Hi everybody. Have you ever thought how important is being able to see for our daily life? We use vision for routine tasks, as reading, driving, to recognize our family faces, or to go out and explore new places. Well, there are millions of people in the world who are not able to do and see all these things because they're affected by Stargardt disease. This disease indeed leads to the progressive loss of the central vision, and this occurs early in the first or second decade of a person's life. And this means people affected by Stargardt are not able to lead independent lives. What then is the cause for this? Stargardt disease patients have a mutated and thus not functioning gene called ABCA4. Mutations in ABCA4 leads to Stargardt in 1 out of 10,000 people in the world. This means 75,000 people are affected by the disease in Europe alone. Unfortunately, no therapy is currently available for this disease. I want to find a way to allow these patients to see, and my idea is to correct the mutated region of the gene inside the patient's cells so that vision can be turned on again. How can I do this? Well, I will need just 3 tools. My first tool is a pair of scissors that I will take from bacteria and use inside the patient's cells to cut and remove the mutated region of the gene. To achieve my goal, I will need to introduce this tool inside the patient's cells. And I will also need to bring in a new correct portion of this gene. And here comes my second tool. It's a virus, which you have modified so that it is not dangerous anymore. Quite the opposite, I will use it as a vehicle for our tools. Once inside the patient's cells, these tools will stimulate the intrinsic problem-solving nature of the human cells. Our cells indeed have their own tailors, which will finally sew together the new correct portion of the gene with the remaining portion of the old gene, so that an entirely correct and thus a functioning gene will be now left inside the patient's cells. How can I test the therapy? In theory, I will need to test it directly in humans, but this is unfeasible. Thus, I will take cells from patients and derive what we call an organoid, a three-dimensional structure resembling the human eye outside of the human body in our laboratory. Then I will test the therapy on organoids. In conclusion, science might be boring, but life not. And in my view, it's our duty to work to give the chance to anyone to appreciate the beauty all around us. And I hope my studies will be helpful along this path. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Ivana. So we'll pass it over to our judges to question you further.
So this methodology of cutting and sewing back, it's something that somebody has tried before, right?
Well, the strategy in general has been already used, the idea to cut. The difficult part in this case is that all the cut and paste strategies are based on tailors, which are not present or are not very active in the cells I need to correct. Thus, the very novel part of this project is that all the strategy is designed so that it will stimulate a tailor which is active in cells which are not proliferating as the cells that I want to target.
So let's say that you won this competition and then you could go ahead and try this, and it worked. So could we scale up whatever you then learned to some other diseases?
I guess yes, for sure, because the idea is just to try if this mechanism of correction can work into the cells of the eye which are affected by the disease. There is a proof of principle that I'm applying to this disease, which is very common, but in theory, if this works, this can be applied to other diseases.
And what type of other diseases then could it be applied to?
It could be applied to all the diseases that affect the photoreceptors, which are the cells in the retina affected by the disease, and especially those as the gene affected in Stargardt, in which you don't have one single mutation, so you don't have to modify one single portion of the gene. In ABCA4, we have 900 mutations spread all across the gene, so it's really difficult to tackle one by one. This approach is aimed to tackle all the mutations which are in one half and all in the other half. So this is for very highly heterogeneous, I would say for heterogeneous genes, and also for large genes.
Perfect.
Thank you so much.
Let's give a round of applause.
Thank you.
So.